Mechanism of organic reactions. Introductions. Chemical reactions happens all around us. When light match start a car, eat dinners, walk a dog. Means I'm giving the practical examples, but chemical reaction is a process by which substance bond together or break bonds. Means maybe they bond together, means the bonding and breaking of bonds. If two compounds, bromine and bromines, they are bonding, but after they are separating, they are called separating. So means chemical reaction is a process by which substance bond together, yeah, breaking bonds. In doing so, either release energy or consume energy. If they will breaking bonds, and then there is energy required to break bonds. If they will form a bonds, then there is energy release in forming a bonds, because in by forming bonds they stabilize. So by stabilizing, there is a release of energy. So in the standard chemistry, we defining the chemical reaction, because we have to learn about the mechanism of organic reaction. Organic reaction, mainly we have to learn about the organic reaction, but we are giving the general chemical reactions definition. Organic reaction, not the chemical reaction. Chemical reaction is the process by which substance bond together, yeah, break bonds. In doing so, either energy release, yeah, consume. I have already written energy release when there will be energy release when the, in a bondings. In bonding there is a energy release, but in the breaking of bonds, energy consumed. So I'm here in the introduction, I'm focusing about to clear something about the reactions. What is reactions? What is chemical reactions? I want to make clear about the chemical reactions. So chemical reactions, practical thing is this: chemical reactions happen all around us when light mass anything. This is called chemical reactions. Then after we will learn about the chemical equation. Chemical equation is a shorthand that scientist used to describe the chemical reactions. Means any chemical reactions happen, the scientist used to describe this chemical reaction by shorthand notation, that is called chemical equation. So chemical reactions, another definition, this is also the definition of chemical reaction. You can also say this is the chemical reactions, and this is also definition of chemical reactions. Here, chemical reaction is a process by which substance bond together, yeah, breaking bonds. In doing so, either energy release or consume energy. Here is also chemical reaction is a process that lead to transfer one set of chemical substance to another. Yeah, by the chemical reactions, if A is plus B, then there is a chemical reaction happen between A and B, then C, final product will be C. So one set of substance transfer to the another set, that is under the chemical reaction. So chemical reaction is the process that lead to transfer one set of chemical substance to another. One set of chemical substance change to another. So in chemical reaction, as there is a forming a bond, breaking a bond, so this lead to a transform of one set of chemical substance to another. Chemical equation, a standard definition, we can say chemical equation is a symbolic representation of chemical reactions or chemical change in the form of symbol or formula. So this, I think all are the definition. I am giving different type of definitions, because I want to make much more clear about chemical reactions. What is chemical reactions? So don't be confused. I am giving this type of definition because I want to be make more clear about the chemical reactions. Chemical equations, chemical equation is a symbolic representation of chemical reactions in the form of symbol and formula, where reactant entity are denoted on the left side and the product entity on the right side. As this is a chemical equation, so this is a reactant entity, this is a product entity. Reactant in the left side, product in the right side. A reactant entity also consists of two things, and one thing is a substrate, one thing is a reagent, and then final product is formed. So I have written this thing: reactant entity are noted on the left hand side and product entity on the right hand side. A reactant generally reactant consists of two species. One is substrate, second is reagent. Substrate, this is a substrate, reagent, then product is formed. So what is substrate and what is reagent? if a plus b equal to c means I am not showing mathematics plus minus, I am showing the chemical reaction. Suppose a, b and c, this is a substrate, this is a substrate, this is a reagent, this is a product. So substrate on which the reagent attack this substrate and the product is formed. So substrate is attacked by a reagent, so this is called substrate. On which the reagent are attacked, that is called substrate. So I have written on which is being attacked is called substrate, means on which being attacked. If two compounds, two atoms, two molecules will be given in the reagent sites, if one is attacked by another, then this is called substrate and this is called reagent. Other which attack the substrate is called reagent. So this is, I am clearing what, who is substrate, who is reagent, or who is a product. So in this way the chemical equation are denoted. Now we, in this chapters, in the mechanism of organic reactions, we will not only learn about what's the chemical equation are happening in the these chapters, but we will also learn how these chemical reactions are happening in the chapters. It is important for us to know not only what happened in the chemical change, but also how it is happening, means how the chemical equations are happening, what's the conditions required, what's the initiative required, what's the reagent required, means whole things we will learn about the chemical reactions. Most of the reactions are complex, means I am saying it is a very simple form, substrate, reagent, A, B, but this is a general form of showing and generally form of making understand about the chemical reactions. But in mechanism of organic reaction, in this chapter we will learn lots of reactions which is very complex. So in complex reactions, they will generally not occur like a reactant and product. They will not occur like this. They will occur via an intermediate, means reactant, means left hand side entity reactant will first convert to an intermediate, then final product they will convert it. So we have to learn about intermediate, what is intermediate. So substrate first will convert about intermediate, then product. In a complex reaction there is a long chain process, so they involve an intermediate, then final product come. But in this small reactions, generally substrate directly converted to product. But for a complex reactions the substrate changes to intermediate, then final product we are getting. Here I have also written most of the reactions are complex, takes place via intermediate which may or may not be isolated. In some compounds, some reactions come intermediate may be isolated, it may not be isolated, it will depend on the reactions. So that thing we will learn later, but here I want to say only that in a complex reactions, reactants not directly converted to product, there is a one intermediate via which reactions proceed. So intermediate are generally very reactive, they react radially with other species present in an environment to form a final product. Intermediates are generally very reactive. The detailed step of description of the chemical reaction is called mechanism, and the substrate, intermediate, product, how they are changes, how they are converted one to another forms, the detailed mechanism, the detailed one by one step if you show in any reactions, then that is called mechanism. If anyone asks about the mechanism of organic reactions, then we have to show the detailed step, each step is substrate, how changes to intermediate, how changes to product. We have to show step by step of detailed reactions, detailed interconversion of the compounds, conversion of the compounds. The detailed steps is called mechanism. We can also say mechanism of reactions. Detailed step by step description of the chemical reaction is called mechanism. Yeah, you can say mechanism of organic reactions, mechanism of organic reactions. Here we are learning organic chemistry, so we are more focusing about organic reactions. We can also generalize in any chemical reactions. So The reactions of organic compounds essentially involve chain existing covalent bond present in the molecule. Generally, in the organic reactions, the organic compounds are covalently bound. So, in covalently bound, if chemical reactions are taking place, then there will be definitely change in covalent bond, which is existing already. So there will be change in covalent bonds, means breaking bonds, making bonds. So there is a change in existing covalent bonds present in a molecule. That's why I have written organic. The reactions of organic compounds essentially involve change in existing covalent bond present in the molecules, because in organic compounds generally covalent bond are present, so breaking and making bonds taking place. So we are writing in the standard way involving change in existing covalent bond present in a molecule. The change may involve electronic displacement in a bond. Change means there is electronic displacement of bond. We will learn about electronic displacement in bond in detail. Breaking of bond, change means breaking, making bonds, electronic displacement bonds. Change, I'm referring about electronic displacement in bond, breaking bond, energy change accompanied by cleavage or formation of bonds. Means there is a change in energy in the breaking, cleavage, breaking of bonds, making of bonds. So actually I'm referring change in this way. What is change? I want to explain in this sentence. There will be breaking bonds, energy change, electronic displacement occur. To understand clearly the mechanism of various organic reactions, we have to learn something basic about this mechanism of organic reactions. We have to know something, some basic concept to understand the detailed mechanism of organic reactions. So we have to learn some construct about what is electronic displacement in bond, what is cleavage breaking of covalent bond, nature of attacking reagent. This basic concept you have to learn to understand, and to learn further about these topics of mechanism of organic reactions, we will learn one by one about what is electronic displacement. We will learn what is electronic displacement, then we will learn one by one cleavage breaking of covalent bonds, nature of attacking reagent. We will learn one by one.